Hello and welcome to another Nikomedia tutorial. So, the tutorial I do today was planned for a weekend, but I got so many requests, and now, some minutes ago, I got a really generous donation too, and so we will do this today. For this one, you need Cinema 4D R20 at least, because we use here the volume builder. And yeah, I did something similar a longer time ago with where I made this openings this with the proximal shader, so this lips and something else. But you don't get with the proximal shader, you don't get such a nice result. But you get a good result, but not something like this. Okay. So let's start it, and I will render it in physical render and octane. And of course, in physical render, it needs of course a little longer. But I don't think that I do the whole animation. I don't render the whole animation, but I show you how you can do everything. So okay, let's start. We start with a sphere, of course. So. We have here another nice sphere, and we put the sphere in a volume builder. So I select my sphere here. Let's see, I don't have it. This is my tutorial layout. So let's go to volumes here, and we need a volume builder, and we need a volume measure, and we need this twice. Let's copy this volume builder here. And name it, let's say this is the base, volume base. And we put in the sphere here. Good, here we make the voxel size a little smaller for now. Let's make 2, this should be fine for now. And here, in the sphere we go to... up here a little bit. Perfect primitive here. So now we have a perfect sphere, and this is what we want. Okay, the second thing is, I will do this with an emitter, a simple emitter. We don't need X particles or something else. We take an emitter, we have it under simulate, particles emitter, and the emitter very small, so 1x1 is more than enough. And I want to emit all around the emitter, so go here up to the high as I can, and here up as high as I can. Okay. What we get is something like this. And that's fine so far. Good. We need, of course, more frames. I go to 500 frames. 500, not 50. 500. Double click somewhere like here. So, and let's see what we need. Let's start with 2x2 here. We don't need more. Stop emission, I would say, but around frame 400. Lifetime, they should burst some at 200. Like this. This speed, we don't need any speed because I want to work just with the turbulence. So I go down with the speed, so it get nothing here, of course. You see? But when I put in now in the simulate and the forces the turbulence, we should see something. See, we get some things. So I go here to 20 and let's say scale 100 for the moment. Now that looks good. But of course I don't want to emit just these particles here. I want to emit another spheres. So let's copy this sphere because we are lazy. Control drag it down and make it smaller. 20 should be fine. And I drag it under the emitter. And when I want that the emitter emits an object, so I have to go to here and show objects. Whoops. Now you see, we emit spheres. That's exactly what we want. Good, next thing I want is an n scale, let's say of 2 with lots of variation. So good. And I want that they rotate a little bit, so let's give it a little rotation. Now that looks fine. See, do, 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 do. Okay. And I want this intersection here because this intersection looks nice later with the soap bubbles when they intersected. This is a very nice effect. Good. What we need now is that this interacts with the volume here. So let's find a nice spot here where it something like this. Here we could see like nice if the lip thing works later. So the next step is I go to my volume base here. Let's copy the volume builder to oopsie. Let's copy the volume builder to volume. Ah, this is the mesh I need. Sorry. Bye bye. Volume mesh. Mesh base. And drag it inside here so we get the mesh. And in the volume here, I drag in. I want to work with the meter inside. But for the emitter, I have to change the size for the emitter later. So first, what I do is I make a new folder here in the base here. So the folder should be somewhere here. Yeah. Okay, let's see. This better here. So the folder is here. I make a new folder. And under this folder, I drag my emitter. So something like this. And you see, okay, we have something. Let's hide the emitter here. Okay, we have the emitter here. This is okay, this is okay. And we see it intersects here, so it works together. Let's make maybe the emitter here, this here, a little more. Yeah, that's better. We can later on make the voxel size smaller so we get a nicer result. But for now, so we can work faster, let it. You see, when I put this to 1, we have a nice result. 1 should be okay for now. Next step, I want to make this emitter a little bigger. And I will show you later why. And, so I make this, and I want to make it bigger. I have to go to in R21. I have this dilate and then erode. And R20 is it's called different. It's called let's. I don't know now, but you will find it. There is another thing for this reshape or something else like this. And +5 here should be fine for the moment. And I want to smooth this out here. So I go to here and smooth it. Now this looks nice so far. And what I want now is I need another folder where I make a bigger version of this sphere. And you will see later of the base. You will see later why. Good. So I make another folder. And drag in my sphere here, the base sphere here. Okay. And make this base sphere as well a little bigger. Let's say 5 as well. So you see, this is bigger. And when I go now with this new folder, with this sphere, you have seen this is bigger, to intersect, then we get something like this. You see? And now you can imagine that when we subtract here the emitter, we get here a nice clip. And this is exactly what we want. So let's make it maybe a little higher. So when I go and make this sphere a little bigger here, we get a higher lip, let's say 8. And if you want it bigger, a much broader lip or something else, you go to here and can make it here to 8 as well or something. You see? But you can change this every time. So good. The next step, I wanna smooth this whole thing now, so that it looks not really nice. Give it a smoothing on top of everything. Okay, but this is a little too much smoothing, so I go to one here. Perfect. And now I bring in my emitter here on top. Okay, and you see we have here the emitter, and here we simply subtract this emitter, and then we have this nice lip going on top, another smooth, and we are done. Smooth, and you see, we get a wonderful thing here. Maybe this one is enough. And this, of course, this works with every geometry, with everything you want. So just make a second part of it, of the base, make it bigger, and here with the emitter, make it bigger too, so that you get this thing, and yeah, that's it. If you do this two, three times, so then you will have this in your brain. So that's it. And the next step I want is when I open and show the emitter now. You see, that works. But I want the emit a little, I want it a little smaller so that it fits inside here. So I make another volume measure in Builder. So this is the reason I said we need this twice. So I have here the volume builder and say volume emitter. And I drag in my emitter here. And I do it with a link, it doesn't matter. So, okay, hide the emitter, of course. Here. So I shouldn't see the. Yeah, okay. Go here to one voxel. And here, again, I use my reshape thing here and say, let's mean minus one. Okay, that looks much better now. And when I go here in the volume base here, let's say the. And let's mesh everything with. And I don't think that we have to go smaller than one. Of course, we need here the mesher too. So this is the mesher emitter. Emitter, mesh emitter. So here and here. Let's hide the sphere here. And so. That looks not really nice here, but let's render it. I start with, oops. Yeah, it's not a bad idea to save it. It's not really a bad idea to save this, this is true. Soap. Soap. Bubbles. Tut. Okay, nice. Yeah, and if I render this now, I have to go to my Octane thing. I show it later with the physical render too. You see, this is quite smooth. It's maybe a little too small here. So, but it's no problem, we go to the reshape here and make it minus 0.5. Ah, that looks better. I want a little thing in between, okay. It looks very nice. And this works now, of course, with all bubbles we have here. This was the whole trick. It's nothing more. Let's make a little lighting and something else. So, of course, I use my scene rig every time. So, and for the moment, I disable the floor here, the catcher. So, you see, it looks really nice. And as I said, if you want now a higher thing here, so let's go to this guy. 10. So it goes a little up, or if you want a broader lip, so let's go to 10 here too. You're totally free, you see, you can do this however you want. 6 here, and well, that looks not so bad. Maybe a little too high, let's go to 8 here. Okay, and I save it. And now, when we have this, or let's bring this somewhere like here. Or here, or here, or here, or here, or here, or here. I don't know. I don't want it. Good. Yeah. Next step, I want to see if this works probably. So, if we hit play now, it could be that it's quite slow. So it's okay. Let's see, it works not really weak here. But what we can do is, we can cache the emitter. We can bake the emitter. So, for this, first I want to disable here my meshes and everything and enable the emitter. So now this emitter, this should be quite fast. See, this NA, I can hide my mesh. Okay, this is what I want. This is nice. Maybe make it, well, we will see it later. We can make it every time. We can make it bigger or something else. Because it doesn't matter, when I make this sphere bigger later, everything will work with it. So we can change whatever we want. We could make in the emitter, if you want, we put in cubes instead. Let's try it later. Okay. I want to cache, but first I'm going to get it. Oh, that's 2 is enough here, that's okay. So, to cache an emitter is quite easy. You go to your simulation, and you have here your particles, and you have your bake particles. And, yeah, I want to bake the particles. Do you want some? Yes, of course, I want the spheres included. Yes, and you see this is very quick. And anyway, now I can scrub through this animation. And can find a nice spot. Sometimes it does not work when you scrub backwards, but in this case, yeah, it works. Let's bring these guys in here. Let's see if we have a nice spot. No, I need a spot where I intersect with my sphere here. So. And let's make it like this. Wait, let's make it zack zack. So I see the sphere, and now I can see where I nicely intersect and where I can work with it. That looks in no way nice. let's give it just more, delete this, give it more with more birth rate. 3x3 and maybe a different seed for now. Let's look how this looks. Yeah, this could be better. And I want the start emission, let's say, minus 100, so it starts earlier normally. Okay, that looks nice. I want now bake. Let's see if we can put the bake with Shift C. You see, I have your bake particles, it's already inside. If you find it, you can drag it out of here. You can drag it somewhere where you find place for your thing. No, I don't want it here. Take it here for the moment. Or here. Doesn't matter. I put it in here for the moment. So I don't have to search everything every time for it. So on the emitter, bake it. So okay, we sub things. Yes, go through, search for a nice thing. So now I could hide this guide, and bring these two back. Yeah, that looks great. Exactly what we want. Good. Let's play with this. Now, I want the camera objects. Not your object, I need here the objects. Contain camera. And here I want to go in my coordinates here. Zero it out here. And zero it out here. So. Okay, I want just 0, 0 and the x and 0. Then. Rest is does not matter for me, and so I make a protection tag here, and the Y and Z I'm allowed to, so I can go up and down or something else. Okay, then let's take the same background picture I used in my original one. Go to my HDRI here, Shift F8 is for the content browser, and I have it. Yeah, I will, of course, my patrons can later on download the project file here. So you get the same images and the same HDRIs and everything like I used. So here it is. Whack. And this should do something, so let's render it. Yay! Look at this. So, that's the same spot like I had in the original one. This was somewhere like here. And you see, an HDRI is mostly not. I have. Most of my HDRIs, I have a high resolution JPEG picture as well. So, you see, this is 3K. And the other one is 8K. So what I do then is, let's render this again, because this is a little washed out. You see, this is just for lighting and reflection. What I do in the rig is go to background and floor, and here I have background picture. And I go to background picture on, and instead of the HDRI, I use the 8K version of this. And you see, okay, this is not really nice here. This we have artifacts here. This is because in the octane settings here, you have to go to the C4D shaders, and this is the resolution is too low. Mostly 4K is okay, and if you see artifacts or something else, go to 8K. But in this case, 4K should be okay. So let's see if we get these artifacts. Okay, you see, now it works perfect. Nice, okay. The next step I want some shadows down here. So, what I do is I activate my floor here, so background floor and shadow catcher on. But the shadow catcher, you see, is a little too high now for our scene. So I go down here and go down with the floor. So it's a nice effect too. And until, I don't know, here is another one. But this is too far down, so. Come on. Okay. And the next step is, I don't want, when we have this animation, I don't want that emitters or spheres dive into this floor. So it's you can't do it with a rigid body tag, because when I put a rigid body tag on the emitter or something else, it would go through the floor as well. And because we have emitter here, the emitter don't recognize this rigid body tags here. So we can do it with a deflector. So let's hide this for the moment. And let's go back and to see our things here. I mean, need just the emitter. And if we scrub through here now, okay, you see they dive into the floor here. And this is, of course, not what we want. Here we have another one. So let's bring in a deflector. Of course, we have to bake later on you. A deflector, and deflector, deflector, deflector. Simulate forces, deflector. Rotate it 90 degrees, yep. If we want it on this, we don't need it on the same height as the floor, because when we have the same floor, the spheres would again dive into the floor, because the particles would be deflected, but the spheres are bigger than the particles, so we need the deflector a little up, a little over the. First, I'd have a look how deep we are with the floor. We are minus 100, go to minus 200 here, so, okay. And now I go with the deflector minus 200, this would be the same. So I have it on the same height as the floor. This is not what I want. So I go with E on the keyboard, I go up a little bit, and of course I make the floor, let's say 50 could be fine. I make the floor bigger, so the deflector bigger. So about 2000 by 2000 should be fine. Bounce, no, I don't want almost no bounce. And now let's see, I play with it. And normally, let's see if, let's see, they deflect, they don't dive into the floor. And this is exactly what I want. Maybe less bounce or no bounce. Let's see how this looks. Do they roll then on the floor? Ah, that looks not bad. Okay. Save this and bake it. Emitter, bake emitter. Okay, yep. Done. Now I bring this guy in here. So. Scroll through and let's find a nice spot for us. Something like that, maybe. Hide this, hide the emitter. We could make a switch in X-Placer so that we don't have to do this hiding and things and everything. But this is not necessary now, I think. So, great. Good, so I think we can start with texturing this guy. Yeah, now you see how nice the shadow here and everything. Everything works fine. Okay. So, for the texturing. Yeah, this was quite easy. I used something kind of marmor texture or something else. Let's see, so materials, do I have the live database open? No. So materials, live database, this could take a little while now. But, yeah, I had it already open, so. Yeah, let's try this one here maybe, or this one, doesn't matter. Try this one. The original one, I used this one, very dark, but now I tried this one. These are from my package, so from a Nikomedia package. You can find it on the Patreon page. Good. Drag it on my volume base. Going on the mesh, of course, not on the volume. Looks nice. Let's see. Let's make this a little darker because I want. So the round edge, this is still here. Nobody needs this. But at least they had fixed some problems. Thanks for this to Otoy. So I'll go down with the power here. So I'm good. Here I have an RGB color for this. This is okay. Okay, we get nice. Yeah, this is nice. I like it. This is okay too. And we can maybe give it a little. Let's see how this looks. Okay, we have this. Yeah, I like it. Save it. And now let's make the bubble thing. Maybe here a little darker. Okay. Save it, and for the bubbles, make a new material, octane material, this will be a specular material, of course, drag it on my emitter measure, and you will see, that does not really look nice here. You can try to put in some since in the transmission I went white, you can try to put in some noise or something else, but I found out it looks better when you give this emitter some thickness, these bubbles. And because of the volume builder, and we will smooth it a little bit, it doesn't get everywhere the same thickness. It's sometimes thinner, thicker, thinner, thicker. And that makes a very nice thing. So I'll show you how I did this. In this material, the only thing what I did here is, in the film width, going to float, I give it a film. You see, this is, we have now this nice bubbles, and you can change this wherever you want. So something like that. And if you want to change some film layer, you can go here and go up here. You see. Now, yes, it's easy to get this nice. Okay, good. And now, to get some thickness in this, I go to my volume emitter here. You see, I have the emitter here. What I do is, I take this emitter here, of course, and this is okay. I make a new folder. Bring the emitter here inside again, and make this emitter even smaller than the first one. So this 0.5. I make this emitter, let's see, -4. Let's see, we will see it. -4. And now I subtract it from this emitter, so this so that we get a hull here. So that this is, and subtract this, and this should give us now, when we smooth this everything out a little bit, could be, you see, now we see nothing because we have too much smooth, so the hull is too thin. So let's go down with here, and we start to see that we get a little, we will see it more in a minute, so that's good. -3. You see this here now. This is not what I want, but when I go a little, you see it on the sides here, a little higher now. Let's go to -3.1, so lower, not higher. More, until my holes are closed here. And now it looks like they are wet, you see, it's great. You see it here, very nice. Okay, that's it so far. Let's see if we find a nice different spot. The animation is clear. So what I did as well is I put all of this. I'm going to show you what I mean. In a null object, all of the, so the emitter, measure, and mesh emitter, so everything of this, and take a null. The null should be exactly in the middle of the, and it is, because we started with a sphere exactly in the middle here, so this is exactly in the middle. Drag everything in this null here. So to make this a little more visible, I again deactivate this and activate the emitter. And in the null, I simply made a vibrate. It can take a vibrate tag or something else. I am not sure how I did it now in my original one. Wait, we can have a look. This is the original one. And I had everything in earlier. I took a vibrate tag with a regular pulse. 180, 180, 180. Okay, that worked, so let's take it in our scene 2. Vibrate tag. So animation tags, vibrate, regular pulse, rotation 180, 180, 180, point 1. So this was this. Did it in relative or normal? I don't know. Normal. So save it. And this should now rotate everything a little bit. But this rotates far too quick. It seems I did not use the same. I did not use the same size here. So. So let's see if this looks. Yeah. But I wanna see if mix. Because if it's. This is great. So far we are great. Yeah, you see, because of the regular parts, we had no, even with the vibrate track tech, we have no hiccup in the loop. So this looks, and this was the reason I did a stop at 400 with the emission. Yeah, we can start earlier. You have seen me because we have here, when we have on the last frame no particles inside, it looks like it would loop. So let's go to the emitter. And here the minus 100 is when I start at zero, it needs longer until the first. So it starts at minus 100 and at, 100, at frame zero is it is, it's quite, I say at frame 100. So. Let's go, we can go with the lifetime down, or we can emission, stop the emission. No, not stop the emission, it's 350. Okay, we have to delete this. Let's see how it looks. Just want that we don't see any particles. This is an interesting one, the big one. When it loops. I think the lifetime is too long, too. And I take a different seat because this one, this big one at the beginning, too, but it could look nice. Let's see. We will cache it and later on see how it looks. Make a different seed here and make the lifetime 150. So, okay, no particle, and now they should come again. Yeah, exactly. And the big one is away because of the other seed. But I want this big one, so let's go back to this one here. Bake it. And let's try to find this big one. And let's see how it looks, because with some depth of field or something else, this could look great, crazy nice. Ah, now it's away. And I have seen the, but this caching that does not really work perfect. That's a pity. This was the big one, was here, this one, but because I've gone down with the lifetime, we don't see it anymore. Maybe we can go down a little higher here with the lifetime, up a little with the lifetime. So we don't have such a big break between the last and the first sphere. Now should the big one should come, no? But 180 is much better. Even 190 could work here. Because I want the break between the last sphere and the first as short as possible, 190. Looks really nice so far. Why they are now? Now I go again to 200. We've been on 200 and it didn't work. So why it would now? Till now everything works fine. That's strange. Now it goes stop emission at 400. Sorry, but I wanna test this because so you see what you have to do when you want to change this. Okay. So now the emission stops. Okay, then the lifetime a little less. But you see, now we would get a very short break here. 180 maybe. And I want this 500 frames, because first this is 20 seconds in my thing here with 25 frames. And 20 seconds you can play on Facebook tiled on the tile bar. I think this disappeared because of the lifetime and not. Yeah, this is okay for me. Good, and now cache this. Or maybe try another different seed too. If it's too boring, please fast forward or something else. But I want to find something very close to us, yeah? I want to see how this would look with the depth of field. Okay, just one more, so one try more and then. Otherwise, don't shoot something to me. And they shouldn't go back here. This is what I don't want to. This, because I don't want that they touch the sphere in the middle again. Let's make less strength in the turbulence. So they shouldn't go back. We have to play a little bit. That looks nice. This is not what I want. Go on the other side. No, 100 was okay. Maybe a bigger scale. You see, with every little change in the settings, you get total different things. That makes it so funny. Now I go back to zero seed. Yes, sir. Last thing. So no, that's too. No, I don't want that it comes come out like this. The average scale may be smaller. Yeah, that seems to be it seems to be much better. Yeah, of course, because they are not all together in the same dimensions. Yeah, that is exactly what I want. That is exactly. You see it, if you have some little patience, it's always worth it. So, boing, boing, boing. It's really, it's often, for me, it's often like this that I, this state here, I sit hours for just in this state. I did everything, but until I find the correct thing for my rendering, sometimes it's really, it's hours. But when, then I'm satisfied. So, nice. So, this emitter, no see, yes see. So, yeah, look at this now. That looks, look at this nice soap, very thin and so that it's, that's it. That's exactly what we want. Let's go to the camera, give the camera a little. Camera image denoiser and go into denoising so we get a very smooth thing here. It's great. And now I want to try a little depth of field. So I go with the focus point to the here and in the thin lens I go down with the f-stop or up with the aperture, whatever you want. It looks very interesting. Look at this nice render. That looks great. And now I want to go back to my thing here. Just want to play with the. Oh, not with this index. You see what it can do here? I get such a nice. That's nice. See, it's just a little bit different, and it looks. Wow, that looks nice. Yeah, I want this. Save it. And yeah, if you want depth of field, you have to. To decide yourself, maybe not so much. Maybe. Okay, that looks nice. But I'm not sure if the autofocus away with the autofocus. But I am not sure if the depth of field is used or not, because on the floor it does not really look. But it looks not bad, of course. I think it looks better without. Okay. Good. So this is now for the Octane. And of course, the animation works now. We have seen it. You have just to test the animation with when you with the emitter, and when the emitter is okay. And you see, like I did, it just disable the meshes. So you have a nice, smooth workflow. And then you have done. So now let's try to do this with the physical render. First, I save this again and save it for the Octane people. Oh, first, that don't give the thing away here. So, We need here the shadow catcher, this guy here, and the background picture. This, no, not the background picture. I need the octane background. This. That's it, what I need here for the scene. We don't have any sun inside, so hide it and delete the octane rig. Bye bye. The camera. RGG. Name it scene. And save it. And save it with assets. Nope. Soap. Bubbles. Dot. Octane. Somehow I activated this spelling things here on Windows, but this is a problem for later. Good, bye bye. Bye bye. Bye bye. Everything bye bye. And the octane camera is no octane camera anymore. The scene does don't need. The camera is now a camera and not an octane camera. Everything. Oh, this was not that. That was not so. It was a little silly. Let's go back because I just saved it over the octane thing now. Go back. Scene, and I have to go back until I see my. Yeah, I see it until I see the materials. So save it now. And now I save this under the desktop. This is a self-published tutorial. Okay. Yes. And now I can delete this one. I can delete this one. I can delete this one. I can delete this too. And now I can save it. So, okay. Bah. That was. Why is this still here? Ah, I deleted, so okay, no, bye bye. Good. Chuck. And yeah, we need first of all the scene rig. And take this one. And we know it from before that the background and floor. The floor is down at 200. We've been at minus 200. I use it so often, everything here, but and every time I have to search. Okay. In the HDRI settings, we know what we need. We want our HDRI here. Okay, let's go here to the low GI render and let's change this low GI to fixed 2. This is 2, not 10, not 16. Ambient occlusion, we don't need here the ambient occlusion. Good. So far, so good. Now we should see something here. Let's see if we see something here. It needs a little time because it calculates the measure here. You see, calculating volume. And now I try this. Okay, we see that we don't see our background here. Let's hide the volumes for the moment. Bring back just our sphere here so it goes faster. What you can do if you have with the volumes, you can of course bake this volumes to an alembic file. So just right click and back to alembic somewhere, let's see. Yeah, back as alembic, or I wouldn't delete it, but back as alembic, then everything works much faster. And it, you can back the whole animation, of course, as alembic. I do this just here just to see if the background works, so if the thing works here, so the scene rig. Background the floor, I don't want to see a background here. At least I don't want to see this background. I want a background picture. So, yes, background picture. And this picture will be as well this one here. We see something. And we... Background off, let's see. First reflection off. Normally we should be fine with this. Oh, I need a compositing floor. Yeah, this is in this case it's a little harder to do exactly. Because when I go to the compositing floor, we get something like this. So we have to make first a background picture for this. So I want to show you again. I showed this sometimes, and I want to show you this again how you do this with here. So we don't need this. I don't need nothing for now here. And no compositing floor. I just want to see my HDRI here. Seen the camera on. Okay. Just to find the right spot now. So I go to here and rotate it until I'm happy with it. So maybe you can. Now I don't see it in the viewport here, doesn't matter. This, nope, it's here somewhere. We come to the... If I could remember where I was, then yeah, now we are here. Okay, you have this thing here. Okay, now I go to my background picture here. Background and floor, here's your little background. And I don't want to see the HDRI setting here, but I've got the camera. So you see, I have now, this is now the picture, so it's not the HDRI, we have the HDRI is off. We have this, let's see if it's true. Yeah, you see, this is just the picture now. And this looks so weird because we have this interactive render setting when I go up here, you see. That gets a nice thing. And now we have here a nice thing in the scene rig. We go, first I go to my Nikon, just background only, this render setting here. I want just to use this. Outputs, let's make it, yeah, for this we make it 720, this is okay. And you have to do nothing, just say how big it should be. And activate just background. Now, there is a thing, let's see if I have it here. Nope, this is, then we have to go in the extensions, user scripts, Nikomedia scripts, and copy background. So, and now I have just this copy background, the render background is the only thing what is activated here now. And when I render this now, because here in the render settings I have this just background, and I just render it. And I get exactly this part of my picture, what I need for this background and this is for the frontal mapping. I explained it better in my when I introduced my scene rigs and everything. You have it in this series. You have this exactly explained. So how you do this, and now I need to save it as PNG or something, whatever you want. PNG 8-bit is enough for this now. Okay, and I save it here as simply background PNG. Okay, that's it. Now we can go back to the LowGI here, delete this. Okay, and now I can use, now I can work with this background pictures. So go to here, and now I can say I want as a background picture, not a spherical picture, I want a flat picture. And this, you see, this would be now the spherical picture, but now I use this background picture. And now you see we have exactly what we need. We have this, and now I can turn on compositing floor and everything works now. Now I get my shadows on the floor and everything. Maybe it looks more difficult like in Octane, but when you do it, sometimes it's you get used to it. So okay, that's it. We have to do nothing more here, nothing more here. Maybe the floor that we go up and down, that you, so that you see that it just works. So we go up here with the floor. You see, we get shadows here, so that's. But we have minus 200, so that we know there is. This should work with the deflector and everything. Yeah, and that's it. We should be exactly there where we've been before. So when I now disable the emitter, also disable, I hide the emitter, I hide this here. And bring back these guys here. And there, this needs, in the, I told you in PR, in physical render, it needs everything a little longer. Unfortunately. But if you would bake this as a lambic, it would go faster. So, we should see something normally. Yeah. Yeah, now we see nicely. We have everything, and now we make a material. So I will start with this almost same material like in Octane. Here I have the Nicomedia's materials on Patreon. You can download it if you're a patron. This was under stone. I'll take here this one, it doesn't matter, it doesn't have to be the same. Okay, I'll bring it on the volume base, the measure base. This should work normally. Let's see if we go down when we go with the volumes. We have here one and yeah, both of one at one. So let's go here. The three, even when it looks ugly, so that doesn't matter. Just want to see if it renders faster. Not much. But I can make this material for this one here at least. So let's go to here. Let's go with the brightness down here. Mm. board down and I want it more rough. Yeah, that looks nice. More roughness. Let's go down here. I want to have a very quick. Okay. Maybe a little less of this. Okay, this should be fine for it. And now I will go back to one here. Disable this guy. And now I need just the barrels, so I disable this guy as soon as this is. So this should. I need just the bubbles to now to do texture. Not this one. This was the wrong one. This one I need. Let's see how quick this renders. Yeah, this is him. But I cannot go much down with this. Because when I go up here, I get problems with the smoothing deformer. Let's wait a little bit, it doesn't matter. So we need a new material. And these are the bubbles. We need just from transparency. And yeah, glass could be okay, why not? Bring it on the measure here, so. I am not sure if it's faster when I cache it. But you see immediately it looks nice. It looks we have the same effect, everything. But we want this the same effect with the nice thin film. So let's go to reflectance and try to put in here a thin film effects. Thin film. See what we get. Boop. At the moment, it calculates it. Does not much. Looks like does not much. Thin film. Thickness 50 nanometer. Color, don't know. Normally we should see something in the. There are samples. Presets. Make it here water. Seems it does nothing for the moment, huh? Do I miss something? Which easily could be. Should be fine. I copy this and bring it. I did not test it before. with the ceiling film, I don't do much here. Paste it here. Oh yeah. This won't work, I think. Okay. Multiply it or add it. And I think it was in the reflection. I'm not sure anymore. That's a little embarrassing. So let's see. Reflectance. Leo Cola, Fresnel, Sampling, should be here. It makes no difference here. I will find it out, no problem. This is not. Let's go here to 2. I should see something. Let's try it here in the transparency channel. Do we have here something? No. Here I want GGX first. Let's see. Adaptive. We will find it out. So let's find it out with me. The layer mask, it can't not be the layer mask. I know that it works somehow because I already did it, but I cannot really remember now how I did it. It cannot be as complicated because when it would be complicated, I never could do it. Let's see, it changed nothing here, so normally we get something in the preview. And that's not really something. Thickness, and let's go here to 5000, maybe this changed something. Or does it not work with the thickness? No, I don't think so. We can test it, so we can simply go to our measure here and disable this here. So we don't get thickness. And it renders faster, so. But this is not the thing we want. Let's bring in a texture. Not a texture, a gradient. Let's see. And in the gradient, I want here a preset. And I want lots of colors, so. That does nothing to, huh? No, because we don't see anything here. Show help. Seems I don't have installed the help. Yeah, normally we don't need it, so why should install it? Something is wrong here, and I don't know what to do. It does nothing, simply nothing. No idea why. So I will make a break here and I will find a way. So I found now a way, and I found the mistake I did. See, now we have this effect, this thin film effect. My problem was, we have to go here to almost no refraction. So if I go here to refraction of 1 or something else, but I want a little. You see, we get this thing, but 1.02 is quite nice, because I want a little refraction, so. And this is it. So just put the thin film shader here in the layer color. Here, now I found my thing, how I like it here. And with these two values, with the thickness and the IOR, you can change the colors, whatever you want. As to, with the spectral samples, you get how many colors it's in it, and so on. So now we got this. And now, no. Let's try to render this with nice thing here. So we are here, is everything okay? Here is, I want this guy here. So that should work so far. And the emitter is away. This is here, this is here. The only mesh I miss is this one. Come back, baby, come back. Do, 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 do. I need the big one. I want the big one. Right, it's now like this. This is not what we want. Oh, I forgot the sphere. I have to make the sphere active, but invisible, but active. So now it works. And now let's render this with a middle GI thing here. Render this one frame here in the viewport with Control R. And let's see how this looks. It should render quite fast. That looks, the thin film is definitely here. Hey, in case it like this, the Octane Render does it better. What we could do is maybe give a little noise in the bubbles. Let's see, go to the emitter. This is everything okay here. It's okay. I will try to give a little noise in the bubble, so let's make it so a render region here. So is this the, let's see. So let's render this region. And it needs to load GI IPR, and let's go with the IPR just to this region here. I want to see just a little bit of the bubbles here. Yeah, every time it needs to calculate the this is the problem with the physical render. But once it does it, we should get normally a faster response. So, noise. Let's see if this does something for us. Or if it destroys again the thin film. Well, I don't think so. Okay, it does. Ah, that looks quite, that looks not so bad. That looks totally not bad. He's waiting. Oh, that's nothing. That is nothing. This could be better. Yeah, maybe it's faster when we disable this emitter here, so it does not have to calculate so much volumes. Oh, that looks not so bad. Bump and give it a little less, maybe 2. Just to let's look it like a little wet. Oh, that's not bad. Maybe 4 and a little bigger. Yeah, why not, little faking is okay. Okay, so I stopped it between a little bit and I made a quick render here, and you see that looks not bad. We have wonderful soap bubbles here. We have a wonderful thing here. It's rendered now with middle GI, so this is quite low settings. But I have now the denoiser on, no ambient occlusion. The denoiser from R21, and the denoiser does a lot of work here for us. Let's render one without the denoiser, so we have a good comparing. The preparing needs a little bit, but it renders quite fast. We know the preparing needs. You see that before it needs 42 seconds. The render itself is quite fast. This is just with one machine, and you see the big difference. We have here 44 seconds, needed longer than with the denoiser. Here with the denoiser, and here without. A big difference. Okay, so we are done, and I hope you liked this. As I said, patrons can download the project files, and yeah, next tutorial will come I think on weekend, yes, of course. And yeah, so far thanks for watching. Hope you liked it, hope you learned maybe something, and if you have requests or questions or complaints or whatever, please write me in the comments. If you want to donate, you will find a PayPal link in the description. And if you want to support me on Patreon, where you can download lots of things and everything, and of course Patreon questions will be will come first of course. And yeah, so if you want to be a patron, if you want to support me on Patreon, so please do so. The link is in the description as well. And I wish you a wonderful day, and hopefully see you soon. Bye bye, and all the best here from Austria, from Vienna, and tschüss und baba.